We are African, and we happen to be in America. We're not American. We are people who formerly were African, who were kidnapped and brought to America.
In a little tent, oh, and just like the river I've been.
Forefathers weren't the pilgrims. We didn't land on Plymouth Rock. The rock was landed on us.
A long time coming, but I know a change gonna come.
Which we do. We invested 310 years of slave labor. 310 years, every day of which your and my mother and father worked for nothing. Not 8 hours a day. There was no union in that day. They worked from sunup until sundown.
Beyond the sky, it's been a long time coming.
The Royalty Project is a program designed to improve self-images amongst youth of color by exposing them to progressive role models, missing history, and the richness of their culture. The program will emphasize achievement, pride, respect, and intelligence in order to elevate self-awareness.
To be black, it means to be unique.
To be black, it means to be powerful, it means to be unique. It means to be like, you start things and everybody just want to follow it.
It means to be diverse.
Powerful.
I'm proud, beautiful, independent. I'm a strong person who never gives up.
She might look like a woman, I mean, she might look like a man, but she is a woman inside.
Okay.
And a beautiful, strong woman.
And a beautiful, strong woman.
Has anyone ever been made fun of? Yeah, I have. I definitely have. And so in this moment, what we're going to do is we are going to be vulnerable and share and have a community that's going to support us through moments like that.
When I was little, I cracked my head twice, and so I got held back in grade, and people called me dumb, stupid, and when anytime we would do anything physical, gym, they would say that I would cheat since I was black, and so...
My hands would turn completely white. Mm-hmm. So they used to call me snowflake or white hands. And I used to not like it. Like it was like very annoying. But you know what? That's in the past.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think people used to call me because I was silly, a monkey.
In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I go.
Amen.
I go.
Amen.
Expect you, veterans, to help usher in everyone who is new. Okay, that work for you?
Okay.
All right, you know how we start. We're going to start with the mission so we all know what we are trying to accomplish here today and throughout this project.
History is all about time, how we tell time, where we're going, and what we have to do. And that's the point of today, exposing the missing history so we can see that things we've done in the past are things that we can do in the future and even better.
Timeline is an icebreaker that requires absolutely no talking. So I want everybody to go on their lips like this. Zip it up. No talking at all. No talking at all. You are going to get in line in order of your birth month and birthday. Birth month and birth date. You're going to get in line, but you cannot talk. At all. Hold on. I got you, Nini. We here. You cannot talk at all. In addition to that, I'm going to come around to your group and make sure that three people in your group are going to have three different handicaps. Brother, what's your birthday?
August.
September 15th. October 11th.
October 31st. November
16th. All right, we got a full line. So we're gonna move into the next activity, which is the factor nine. Brother Jahi, you wanna expand on sharecropping and convict leasing?
I think it's no because, well, people still have slaves. It's just that, you know how people kidnap people until they take them?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like that, because since the other side won the war, that means slavery wasn't allowed anymore, but people hid slaves so because they could then, if they didn't have any, they would still have to pay people to work for them.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So then they would not, so then they wouldn't have anyone to work for the farms and grow the crops.
Okay.
Strong answer, my brother, strong answer.
That's why they said, oh, the Sphinx nose came off for no reason. Mm-hmm. Well, one of the theories is that they cut it off to make it look like, oh, we don't know. If it was most likely its nose was pointed like a white person.
Okay.
And it most likely was shaped like the Sphinx.
Okay. From this side, why do you say what you're saying?
I don't really have a strong answer for this, but I think we used to be the people who, it was the opposite, but now since they came, it turned around.
Okay. They hated anything, they hated oppression, right?
Yep.
That's what they hated, right? They want all people to be in power. And it was actually going against the forces that was making people unempowered, right?
They said white power to white people, black power to black people, brown power to brown people,
yellow power to yellow people.
So they were all powers.
That the 13th Amendment abolished all forms of slavery.
I don't understand what the 13th thing is, but I'm going to go with the fact because it means end, I'm guessing.
Mm-hmm.
And slavery did end at 18 something.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just gonna go with that.
Okay. Be the educated guest, my sister right here.
I'm
Okay,
Lots of
Rebellion for 500.
Woo! Okay, okay.
Okay, Brother John Freeden.
This religious leader was inspired by his vision of freedom for African people. He led a rebellion in Southampton County, Virginia. Twins joined at the back of the head, converted to Christianity, and disguised their practice as Zit. Amazing contributions to supporting the...
Who is that Turner?
There we go.
Woo!
The rebellion?
That is correct! Yeah!
Trade route used by European merchants.
That sounds right.
What in the middle passage?
Team Ian.
Yoruba.
Correct.
What is?
We have a steal.
What is Mofo?
Who is Nanny?
Wait. Who is Nanny is correct.
Yay!
What is the Moors? Who are the Moors? Correct.
They went for the steal and they are
correct.
Correct. Your effort. Your integrity in terms of playing the games, your intellect, your camaraderie, how you help each other, help one another out, that was beautiful. And we love you and we're sending you love and light and thank you for participating today.
And we want to just start off with a quick icebreaker, okay? So everybody received the card, right? Index card. Raise your index card from the air. If you ever receive, please let us know.
We want you to brainstorm and sort of think about some of the lessons learned in the past workshops and give your future self some advice.
I wrote, dear charity, don't spend all your money. You'll be beautiful and don't let nobody or boy say you are not. All your bills, stay black and be different and get a scholarship from college.
So what do you mean by don't spend all your money? Spend it all your life. And how old are you, Charlie? Good, okay, all right. So that's good at the end. Very good. And your name is Charity, too, so, you know.
I
would
pull out conversation. Oh, God.
Don't let people push you around. Show them who's boss.
All right.
Then I play. Get stronger, get faster, make the basketball, football, and track team. And get taller than Lewis.
Okay, guys. So mentors. Basically, this is the career profiles, right? So you guys want to be, as we spoke, financial consultants, the life coach. So what's gonna happen is they're gonna pick their jobs, and basically you guys are gonna walk them through this with their income sheet, which you'll see in a few, and you're gonna match it. And you're basically going to look at the different stuff, the type of commute to work, the type of things that you use to commute to work, as well as the various different things that affect their life, all right? So you guys just kind of want to look at this and compare it to what they choose and the choices they're making to help them through their balance sheet or their income statement, all right?
Okay, did everybody hear that?
It's tough to be an adult.
That is tough to be an adult. Explain that.
Well, you have to pay rent, mortgage, fitness, or if you do take fitness, you have to get your food, you have different types of food that you get, you have to get your clothes in, you have to get your grooming, your hair, present yourself to go up and you have to work with your tax.
Taxes. How
does
everybody feel about taxes?
Powerful.
I love them. Took a lot of money, right?
We came with the name YBT, which stands for Young Black and Talented. Mm-hmm. And it's basically a youth development. It's basically a youth development center, and we develop like talent such as music, money and finance, comedy, fashion. And yeah, all of
those. Our company is called the Digital Gaming Virtual. The Virtual Gaming System.
Industry.
VGI for short. And towards the community, it can help kids, you know, learn how to dance, work on their vocabulary. It helps them step out of their comfort zone.
Artists
gamers and readers and wordsmithing is are the people who created it. So we try to focus on dancing, like she said, reading and vocabulary, character development, you know, develop the person's character, you know, get to create your avatar, develop their character, and as well as develop your own self-confidence, help to stand out, update your talents, your own talents, increase your creativity, and come out of your comfort zone, like she said.
I just heard your mentor is a lawyer.
Yeah.
Right? So did that help you guide you through the process? Do you feel like it helped? Okay, the
stuff that you
went through.
What are some things you learned from her?
The real struggles.
I just thought it was really interesting to watch him in his process because,
I have a teenager. She's older now, but I'm a mother. And it just was interesting to see as soon as it became his money and his salary. It was very much like, I don't need that, and I don't need that. With almost everything, he had an alternative, you know, even the food. Like, I'm good with that. I can eat at my friends or my family's house. I can eat everything. And I'm like, first of all, that's cheap. I'm like, that's not cheap. Like, I like that mentality that you were thinking about what you really don't need to spend money on and how you can save your money. And then alternatives. It wasn't just, I don't need that. It was, I can do it this way. I can try this thing. And I think that there's something to be said for that type of mentality.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Is that substance that accounts for what black people refer to as soul. We move differently, we walk differently, we talk differently because we have access to a different form of energy than other folks.
Your forehead, that's an African way of dapping yourself up. If you're an African dancer and you're really getting it, the elders come around and just give you it right in your pineal gland. Just activate the melanin. Activate it. Give yourself a little activation.
Excellent. Wasn't that fun? Yes. Y'all are dope.
And our reshape. Who wants to tell me what the reveal was today? What did we reveal today?
History.
Okay, specifically what? Or what did we reveal today?
What did we reveal?
What did we release today? What did we get rid of? Okay, what did we reshape? What was the reshape?
Reshaped our minds about our future plans.
Yeah. Kamari.
The reshape was when we asked our parents for money.
Be considerate that your parents have a budget that they have to go between because you did that. You did that whole exercise.
I feel like I have to be more careful with
how I spend. More careful, more thoughtful, right? More thoughtful. Okay. Louis, what did we reveal today?
We revealed that when you're an adult, you have to make set sacrifices and
that our insides can explode, she said.
We think about ourselves different in a good way, and how we see ourselves around others.
That's great.
Absolutely. Because if we just go through our academic education on what melanin might be, what would we have known before today? That melanin just gives you the pigment of your skin and the texture of your hair and the color of your eyes.
It's so much more than that. It's so much more than that.
We are not inferior. We dominate. We are not inferior. The fact that we are black does not make us less than. Just because we are, that makes us greater than.
So understand that. That's why we dominate everything that we do. So don't ever get it twisted. Next time you walk into a room of white folk or an elevator, do this. Walk right in.
Absolutely. We reshaped our mindset about how we approach our history. It is not up to anyone else besides ourselves to learn, to teach, and to embody our history.
Mm-hmm.
Ashe?
Ashe.
All right.
Kings and queens.